the Attorney General of India, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, in a rare television interview. Mr. Rohatgi, thank you very much for joining me. I don't know if you've been following the many news reports that we here at Times Now have put out on Mr. Vijay Mallya's misdeeds. But when did you find out that Mr. Mallya had left the country, that he had fled?
You see, I had mentioned this case to the Chief Justice of India yesterday. He was kind enough to post it for hearing today. So I was a little busy in the morning. I requested the court concerned to take it up at 2 p.m. So at lunchtime, I was getting conflicting reports from the media that Mr. Mallya had gone away. So I checked with the CBI, and I was informed that apparently he had left India on 2nd of March itself, and I told the court so.
How did one wing of the government not tell the other wing if the CBI knew that he had left the country on the 2nd of March and you only got to know now? Isn't that strange?
No, see, Arunab, this was a civil action. I am appearing for a consortium of banks led by SBI. Now, they are not privy to information which may be available with governmental authorities. It was because I was conducting their case and I could, tap CBI to find out. That is why I did so. That's how it happened.
What were the banks doing till now? That's the question everyone across the country is asking. The banks are owed over 6,000 crore rupees. What were the banks doing till now, Mr. Rohatgi? This is a man who would obviously try to flee India because he doesn't have the money to pay back.
I will tell you, Arunam. The loans were granted in the year 2000, a little earlier, say about 5 or 7 years ago, when Kingfisher was doing well. Security of two immovable properties was taken, and there was security in relation to the aircraft business, including the logo, the brand name, etc. Unfortunately, the brand name and the business of Kingfisher slowly started declining, and today has become defunct. So a large amount of security from the airline has become defunct. And the value of the properties, two properties in Goa and Bombay respectively, are not more than 400 or 500 crores. We have sold some shares also, the banks, and they have recovered maybe 1,000 odd crores, but still about 6,000 to 7,000 crores is due. Mr. Mallya has been saying over the past 2 years that he is willing to settle, he will settle, he will not run away, he is not an absconder, all that he has been saying. But as far as I am concerned, when the banks came to me last week, I told them to be proactive and move the DRT for various reliefs, including impounding a passport, disclosure of assets because there are personal guarantees, and a freezing order in relation to the 700 crores which he was about to receive for exiting USA.
Mr. Rohatgi,
Mr. Rohatgi, we went to the High Court. From the High Court, we came straight to the Supreme Court. And the court today, after hearing us, has directed issue of notice. I told the court that he's probably gone away.
Mr. Rohatgi, hear me one minute. Can you hear me, Mr. Rohatgi? The question is simple, Mr. Rohatgi, out here. Question is simple.
Yes, yes.
You first mentioned a brand name. I don't know anyone in the world who will get 7,000 crores against an intangible asset of a brand name. The immovable properties are not worth the kind of money that the loans would give as a collateral. You mentioned in the court today that Mallya possesses movable and immovable assets far in excess of what he owes the exchequer. If that is the case, why doesn't the government go and seize all his assets, Mr. Rohatgi, and then take the money and give it back to the bank so that they can give it back to the taxpayer?
Yeah, I entirely agree. I wish it was as simple as that. But a lot of his assets are abroad. They are not within India. So if assets are abroad, it's a long drawn process. You cannot go and seize the asset in England or in South Africa.
Yeah, but then why was...
That's the issue. Yeah. I'm not really concerned with the merits of the case.
Yes, but
that will go on. I was really concerned with one relief that he should be asked to come to India
and
maybe deposit his passport so that we can ask him about disclosure of personal assets.
Mr. Rohatgi, you know that as we are reporting this, there is such anger across the country on Vijay Mallya, because Vijay Mallya represents somebody who uses the system, uses his connections, networks with politicians, bureaucrats and journalists to get away. You told the Supreme Court today that the Mallya left the country the day you moved court, which is correct. Has he been allowed to get away because of the delay? Why did you wait for all these months before you moved the court? Why didn't you move the court earlier? You as in the banks, the consortium of banks which you represent.
No, I mean, but see, they have their own story to say. I have not been appearing in this matter earlier except for today. It appears to me that they were trying everything. In DRT, in the high courts, there was various rounds up and down. They could seize possession of one property in Bombay under the Sarfaisi Act. More than 100 or 200 hearings went by. Unfortunately, our system is very slothful and lethargic, and it went up and down various tribunals. I agree with you. If some more proactive action had been taken, maybe some more tangible results would have come.
Mr. Rohatgi,
but unfortunately, I came on the scene only
Mr. Rohatgi, 500 adjournments by the DRT. Right? 500 adjournments by the DRT, and banks were continuing to give him loans when he was defaulting on the payments. You know what IDBI Bank did? My question to you is, though you represent them, do you feel there are no questions to be asked from the bank managements? Are they not answerable for whatever their conduct is, slothful or otherwise?
I think you are right. I think you are right. An in-depth investigation has to be made, not only in this case, but there are many such cases which are floating around in this country as to how it has happened that there are such large outstandings. Investigation should be done, and if there are erring officers in the banks or consortium of banks, they should also be brought to book. I am not a sympathizer either for the debtor or his companies. I entirely agree with you. It's ultimately public money. It belongs to you and me. And in fact, I told the judge it also belongs to the judges. It belongs to everybody. So I am not trying to, shut out anything. Let there be a full investigation. In fact, the finance minister has been on record in the last 1 week saying that they will not spare any defaulter. I think we should vigorously take such proceedings to their fruition, whether it is this case or couple of cases or scores of cases of similar types.
Now, Mr. Rohatgi, with the CBI and the Enforcement Directorate now examining these loans, is there, in your view as the Attorney General of India, would you say as the Attorney General there's a certain element of criminality that is involved here?
No, Arunab, I cannot make that statement. I have not seen the papers of loan or how loans were given. As I told you, my limited brief today was to somehow get a deposit of his passport, Mr. Mallya's passport, in the court so that we can ask him about personal assets overseas. I don't know, but it's obvious that CBI is examining and probing. And as far as ED is concerned, I checked with ED. They have registered a case only a couple of days ago.
What if he chooses?
They will decide what the criminality is.
You know, the example of Lalit Modi comes to light, Mr. Rohatgi. You know, once again, as the Attorney General, you know, my question to you will be, what if Mallya chooses not to come back like Lalit Modi, which is entirely likely? He's gone away on the second because he's run away from this country. What if he chooses not to come back? What are your options then?
Well, the first option is to ask him to appear, and if he does not appear, to take proceedings for revocation of his passport. Once his passport is revoked, then technically, if a person does not have any other right to reside anywhere else, then he becomes a stateless person. And then the country where the person is forces him to go back to the country from where he has come. That is the usual procedure which is available for feature of somebody's passport.
It did not work in the case of Lalit Modi.
That also does not work. Then No, just a minute. As far as Mr. Modi is concerned, revocation of passport proceedings were taken, but they were quashed by the Delhi High Court. Now, I have read in the papers that extradition proceedings have commenced because we have an extradition treaty with the UK.
That's right.
So the next step after revocation is an extradition treaty, even if a person holds a different or a foreign passport. These are things which are available in the legal process, but obviously they are lengthy and time consuming.
Well, I think it's at least important that you do say today, in the course of this interview, that the bank managements must be investigated, because you are aware more than anyone else, Mr. Attorney General, that the anger in India today is as much with what Vijay Mallya has done as it is with the banks that have given him a long rope. So I hope that you'll follow up on what you told us today.
I will. I also sympathize with the people of this country.
Well, I think they need justice. They need justice from Vijay Mallya. The government should follow up. Thank you very much, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, for joining me. Thank you.